And I am back at it once again with another stream for you guys tonight and tonight. Welcome to the season finale of Fortnite Fridays. We're going to be ushering in a new season of Fortnite. So I cannot wait to play with you guys and chat with you guys here tonight. Real quick, before we get started, I do want to say that I'm going to be inviting someone. So I'm going to have someone play alongside me. That's right. It is my bro Joe, aka Inferno Man 87, aka Official King Wolf, aka 2 Pro Gaming Joe, aka Explicit. So welcome. Glad to be playing alongside. Us. Hello. How are you? Alright, we got my bro Joe. Joe, welcome to the channel.
What's good?
Yep, this is actually your first time on my Twitch. So how does it feel?
It feels pretty good. How you been?
Oh, can't complain. But yes, we are live on Twitch. So, yes, guys, this is the Fortnite Friday season finale. How you feeling, Joe? Do you feel like we're going to get a win here tonight?
Yes, I do.
Well, I hope so. And we just had someone join our chat. Hello to that person. How you doing? You're doing great. Doing good. You're kind of in the middle. How you feeling?
You know what? I'm going to check your stream right here and see if I can hear myself for you so you don't have to worry about all that. All
right.
I got you. Let's see. We got Austin Sweet.
Yep.
You know what? Yeah, I can hear myself.
You can? All right.
I'm over here eating a salad that, like, I put cheese, saltines in, and then cut up, like, 4 meatballs, so I add some meat, some protein in this bitch.
Yeah, you got protein in there, but it's just mostly, is it mostly cheese? Hey, we had another person join. Hello to that other person. How you doing? Doing great. Doing good. You're kind of in the middle. This is the Fortnite Friday season finale.
And so everybody knows... Oh, my bad, Austin. If you want to talk, you can.
I was actually getting ready to say, I, of course, will be missing the event tomorrow because I have to go to work.
But, you know, that's exactly what I was going to bring up. Austin's going to give me the rights to his channel for a day. I'm going to say here, stream the live event tomorrow, post at Dawson's YouTube channel. And, you know, so just come check me out at official_KingWolf. You can find it on my official_KingWolf YouTube channel and or Austin's, you know. I'll just upload it to his as well.
Yep. If you guys want to go check it out, do yourself a favor. Go follow Official King Wolf on Twitch. He really deserves it.
Yeah, my YouTube's just King Wolf. But okay, Austin, we are going to be landing at Tilted, of course.
Tilted? Alright, let's get it.
Unless you want to land at the new Collider point of interest right here.
Tilted's fine. By the way, Big Game, did you see anything different?
I mean, the Collider?
Yeah, new Glider. Look at this. Look at this Glider.
Oh, glider. I said collider.
Yeah, look at the glider that I have.
Is that the Matrix one?
Yeah, I got it mainly because it kind of looks horror movie related, so it looks really cool.
Wait, when did you get that? Just today? Because that was an event thing that you only got for doing an event.
Yeah, I got it. I got it today, actually.
Oh,
I was changing up my glider, and I also have a katana.
Yeah.
So, I kind of switched it up a little bit, considering you know, the finale. Tonight's the finale and all that. So.
Yeah, the finale's going to happen at 4 p.m. tomorrow.
Yeah, but as far as the series goes for me, tonight is the season finale of Fortnite Fridays, unfortunately.
But as stated, I'll upload the event to Austin's channel as well.
Yep, so get ready for that, guys. That's gonna be lit. I can just go ahead and tell you that much.
Yes, My bad. I feel like a prick.
You're fine. As long as you don't have to go to work.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. As long as I don't got work or some shit.
Yeah, because if he has to work tomorrow, then we're going to feel real bad because you guys are going to miss out on the event.
But you can just tune in to Cypher PK.
Yeah.
Okay, I just killed the kid.
I just killed someone too.
Hell yeah, hell yeah.
I just got my first kill. So that is awesome. Hopefully everyone out there is ready to go for the weekend.
Oh, great God, Austin.
What's wrong?
Guess who just texted me? Woohoo!
Oh, no. Do I want to know?
Who did I tell you I left a message for? And don't even say their name, but you know who I'm talking about, right?
Yes.
Okay, Austin, come here. I got us a keg. We're about to cop a motherfucking dub. And if you think we're going to get a dub in Fortnite, give me a hell yeah.
Hell yeah. And if you guys don't know what that means, I'm a big WWE fan, and Stone Cold Steve Austin's my favorite wrestler of all time. So that's how we kind of...
The one thing me and Austin agree on.
Yeah.
Me and Austin's favorite wrestler is both Stone Cold. I about called him Sting Cold.
Come on.
Hey, wait, somebody's ceiling over here, Austin. Let's get him. Let's get him. Austin, they're wearing your fake banana skin.
Wait, what?
They're copying your banana skin.
Nobody jacks my swag and gets away with it. Oh, no. Big game. Ow. Dang it. They're inside the tank.
I know.
Oh, no.
I'm destroying.
Destroy it and let's get him.
I killed him. He didn't hop out the tank.
That was his own dang fault.
He didn't hop out the tank.
That's his own dang fault. So that's not our problem. I'll take that.
Yeah.
What? Only one bullet. Big game. Do you have anything for a heavy sniper rifle?
Yeah, here.
Yeah, give me some sniper ammo. Well, like I said, this is actually Joe's first appearance on my Twitch channel, believe it or not.
If you guys don't know, he has appeared on mine as well before, but, like, this is my first time on Austin's.
Yep, I have appeared on... Have I appeared on your Twitch?
Yeah, when we were doing Warzone and shit, but I remember we had to delete them because the audio and all that.
Oh, yeah.
Let me see what she be saying here. Should I read it out for everybody to hear?
I don't know. I mean, if you want to lose viewers, here,
You know what? I'll read it out loud, and like if it's anything serious or something, I'll just leave it out. Hey, I know it's been a while, but I just wanted to tell you a bit of what's going on with me. First off, I want to start off with saying I'm sorry I blocked you. But I have chronic Lyme's disease and found this out a few weeks ago. Not only that, but my heart isn't working properly. I'm getting a heart monitor on myself this Monday. I'm only telling you all this because I feel since you've known me a majority of your life, you have a right to know.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I actually kind of feel bad, but like...
That is
oh
awful.
Shit, Austin! It just pulsed again. That big device over there is the Doomsday device that's supposed to, quote-unquote, destroy the map. Also, for you guys that don't know, we're also supposed to be going to the moon for the live event. It's called the Ice Moon, where we're gonna be, getting the mecha, team leader robot, and... pair of three other players will be controlling a limb of the mecha robot to fight something and take down this Doomsday device.
That actually sounds like a really dope concept.
After the event is over, there's going to be about 12 hours of downtime.
Yeah, so that's why I'll be back in 2 weeks.
Here, Austin. You drive. You drive, and I'm gonna
really?
Send your text. Oh,
really? Why are you gonna let me drive?
Well, I gotta text Sam back. I actually kind of feel.
Alright, fine. Oh my god, the music kind of sounds slapping this. In this truck. Oh, this is like, it's giving me corn vibes. This is amazing.
Oh, I know. It literally felt like corn to Switch.
But I'll go ahead and say now to the people that follow me on Twitch, I will not be back with Fortnite Fridays for like, in like 2 weeks. So in 2 weeks, you guys will get the season premiere of Fortnite Fridays. Ah, no, low fuel. Big Game, we're gonna have to get out.
I will.
Oh, come on. Get out of the ding-dang car.
Alright, there we go. My bad. I was just texting her back because I actually feel bad if that's true. Like, you know, I know, like, me and said person's been through a lot, but, like, damn.
Yeah.
I don't bring up names just so, you know, like, I don't bring up names. It's not our the viewer's business, but, like, I honestly just wanted to read that to you.
Yeah, I don't blame you. Dang it, they're getting away!
Yeah, they did.
Do you have anything for, an SMG? Any ammo? Ready for the event tomorrow. I know Joe is. I, unfortunately, like I said earlier in the stream, I'm gonna have to miss it, unfortunately. Sad, I know, but Joe's gonna be
Donald Mustard.
What?
Donald Mustard, aka Donald Mustard, aka one of the creators or lead designers for Fortnite, said this event right here is gonna be is one of his favorite and his favorite part of the Fortnite story so far.
Huh.
Literally, he says everything has been leading up to this. Like, dude, I'm so hyped.
What happens if it fails to live up to expectations?
Well, disappointment.
Yeah, and it gets a big wah, wah, wah. Like, what the hell? Like, what were... We were expecting this, this, and this, and we didn't get this, said this, this, and this. We got something...
I always keep farming mats thinking this is build mode.
Big Game, it's not build mode. And let's hope with this next, like, season or whatever, they keep no build.
Oh, they will. Far too popular.
Far too loved. It's far too loved, in my opinion.
Oh, it really is. It's literally brought back most of the player base.
And that's good.
I mean, you got Fortnite pros who's not... I seen a gunshot behind us.
A gunshot? Really?
You do got the, or the visual audios on, right?
Of course.
Alright, where you can, like, see the gunshots and footsteps and shit on your screen?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Alright, good.
Oh, yeah, I mean, if you want to cuss on here, that's fine, but I just don't cuss.
No, that's fine. I don't try to. It's not something I like doing all the time. It's
all good, yeah.
Also, guys, what is today, Austin? The 23rd, or the 3rd?
3rd, yeah.
You know what? Starting tomorrow, I'm gonna get back into streaming.
Big Game?
Yes.
I got 3 words for you.
Yes.
It's about time.
I thought you were going to get me oh, hell yeah!
Nah. But I'll go ahead and get...
Man,
I'm gonna hit
I was...
You.
Go ahead.
We really got to stop cutting each other off.
We've been doing it all day today.
It's kind of getting repetitive. You just want me to go first? Because I'm going to hit them with a little bit of music history.
Wait, what is this? Plant?
What the...
Oh, I planted a plant.
It's an info... Creation creator, okay, and there you go. Ah, what
Whoa,
the?
They're behind us, they're behind us.
I'm already seeing the footsteps. Wait, let me switch my sniper.
Oh, they're... Wait, where?
Missed.
Got him.
Did you get him?
Yeah, what the fuck were you thinking, kid?
What was he thinking?
I don't know, but his foolish acts got extinguished. Also, guys, yeah. Me and Austin got to... I got to do a quick shout-out here, Austin.
All right, go ahead.
13 years in the making, MC Renz, Osiris is out now on all platforms. Make sure you go check that joint out. It is fire.
In fact, why don't we
Except
do...
Except for the track fire.
Yeah,
Except
why don't
for
we
the
do...
track fire.
Yeah, why don't we do, like, a little mini-review of Osiris, like, right here, right now.
Alright, hold on. We got a ton of shit here.
But I'll go ahead and say this now. Guys who are watching this, you guys should know who MC Ren is. If you don't, I really don't know what to tell you. Go on Wikipedia, look up MC Ren. Wikipedia is your friend. But this EP guy
you know the
from
group
MC Ren...
You know the group NWA? You know Ren. You know the song Straight Outta Compton and Fuck the Police? You know Ren.
Yep. But yeah, everyone should know who MC Ren is. Like I said, if you don't know him, then I literally don't know what to tell you. You're heading into the storm. What are you doing?
I just downed kid. His teammate's over there.
But yeah, guys, this is 13 years in the making. This is literally his latest project since Ren Incarnated, which came out in, what, 2009?
Yep.
So this EP is 13 years in the making. Joe, why don't you go ahead and start us off by giving us your thoughts on the EP and then we'll take turns. Whoa!
My
what
overall...
You
oh no, he's right up this hill. My overall thoughts on the EP, I want to say it's a solid... I want to say it's all... I can't even say it's all killer, no filler. We have
one bad track. Literally, just one.
Austin, he's right up there. Austin, turn around. He's behind you.
Behind me?
He's behind you. Okay,
ah,
Austin,
crap.
He's zipping away.
It's a storm. Ow, crap.
Austin, you can get him.
Stop.
It's okay.
We were close.
It's okay.
Alright, ready up. So close. So close. Yo, dude, we were so close.
Yeah, we were. And then you get hit up with tryhards.
I hate tryhards. But anyways, continue on with what you were saying about MC Ren and his album Osiris.
On Eden here. Let me cleanse the palate.
Because I literally thought that the EP had some really good songs on it, except for one track in particular.
Like I said, this whole album, throughout the entirety of the EP, you feel the 80s and 90s vibes, especially since Ren is from the 80s and 90s. But, like, you feel the 80s and 90s in each and every track, and that's also due to the chill of Compton's Most Wanted producing every single track. So I guess that 80s vibes to the production, and then you also got Ren on it and a lot of other 80s artists. So you feel the 80s and 90s on it. But every track, I want to say, is fire, except for the track called Fire featuring Corrupt. And not to say anything bad against the artist, because the verses were solid. It was just the beat and the hook. Honestly, it was the worst part of the album. Like, I just did not like it. Track 4, Fire, it should have been extinguished. That track's trash. I'm sorry. I'm a real MC Ren fan. He's my favorite artist of all time. But, dude, I cannot stay here and defend that track. And, Austin, I'm over here.
Oops, sorry. But, yeah, I have to agree that Fire should have been extinguished.
That was not a good track, honestly. If you replaced the intro with something else and kept Fire off the project, I think I would have been fine with it.
Yeah, I think, in my honest opinion, I think Back At It would have been the perfect fit.
King Villain and Back At It?
King Villain and Back At It would have made a better placement. But yeah, I think the EP overall was good. It does take you back to the 80s and 90s vibe of MC Ren. When MC Ren was like with Straight Outta Compton, he was in, he did his solo stuff.
Yo, Austin, come up here. Watch,
I mean,
don't kill him when you come up here. Do not kill him. But watch.
Okay.
I caught him on fire with the blowtorch.
Interesting strategy. But, we'll say this now. If you like, Shock of the Hour, Villain in Black, and Ruthless for Life, then you will really like this album, this EP.
Especially if you liked Ren Incarnated the most, in my opinion, since that's kind of what he sounds like on this album.
Okay, now why am I if I shoot him?
Don't. You're gonna have to fight him.
Ah, crap. Let's not do that. Let's not do that unless we say we did.
You know what, Austin? I have so much gold here. Take one.
Ah, sweet. Thank you.
If you zoom in with it, you can see where the storm's gonna end. See where the storm at the bottom left?
Aw, dude, that is lit.
It shows you where the storm's gonna go, so that means if we go there, we'll be inside the storm. Or the
dude,
circle.
That is so cool. Alright, but now let's get to the pros and cons of the EP.
Pros? Almost everything about it. I love the entire album. My favorite track is on The News and then The Time, or then Time. Honestly, those two tracks are instant hood classics.
Cons?
Fire.
That's all we gotta say. But, yeah, I'm gonna say my pros now. The pros, pretty much, the second half of the EP.
Oh, I downed her! Got her.
Dang it, I wanted to finish that person off.
Yo, you should use that rifle, dude. It slaps.
But yeah, but I think the whole EP was great except for Fire.
Yeah, Fire needed some improvement.
Yeah, and I just want to say one thing before we continue on talking about Osiris.
Yes.
What are you guys still doing here?
Go check it out!
Go check out the EP and then come back and let me know in the chat how you guys feel about it. But 1 to 10, I'll start by rating it first. I'm going to give it a solid 8 to a strong 8.5. That's how I kind of feel about this.
I have to agree.
I mean, if Fire was taken off and you replaced it with either King Villain or Back At It, then we would be looking at like a 9 or maybe a 9.5. Do you agree with that?
Yes.
I totally agree with that. But yeah, Osiris is great. I would probably say it's better than Kendrick's album.
Oh, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers, I hated that album. I'm sorry. To all the K-Dot fans, I'm sorry. I can't.
I can't either. Like, where do...
You had years to make it. You had years, and you hit us with that.
Yeah, you hit us with the lowest hanging fruit.
Hey, Austin, look, it's you.
Forget you. But yeah, I'm gonna have to say that Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers was, in my honest opinion, just one of the most overrated rap albums of 2022 so far. Not a fan.
Man, I'm just spending all my gold now, partially because I have like 3,000 of it, and weapons are on sale. On top of all that, I only have this 3,000 gold till tomorrow.
There you go. But, yeah, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers, you know, dodge this album. Dodge the album, I'm telling you. It's not worth it. Dang it, I gotta reload.
Got him.
It gave me
how many kills you got? I got 6.
I got 1, because it gave me the kill.
Here, Austin.
But yeah, to the people out there that, to the people out there that think Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers is his best album, no. Not even close.
I just don't enjoy it. I find, like, most of the tracks to just be pointless. Not even pointless, just, I don't vibe with it.
I think the only, songs that I like remotely off that album is, like, N95.
N95 was a banger.
N95 was a banger. I feel, like, a strong to moderate 2 on this.
Wait, you didn't take the other one? Hold on, I'm gonna go back for that other half pod then.
No, I didn't take it. I'm almost full on shield. What would you rate the album?
Like I said, I gave it like a high 7. Or not a high 7, a high 8.5.
No, Mr. Morale.
Oh, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. I give that shit like a 5.
I gave it like a 3. I give it a 3. Shit's... Cause... N95, in my opinion, saved it. I tried listening to it, I just can't get through the album.
Honestly, I thought,
Hey, Big Game, what are you doing? You're not gonna wait for me? God! Stop blaring the horn! Get rolling! Whoa! We're airborne!
You didn't know you could do that?
I didn't know until now. But yeah, as far as Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers is concerned, guys, dodge that out.
Alright, well, we have to go back this way, anyway.
To me, Kendrick's best albums are,
To Pimp a Butterfly,
Good Kid, Mad City. Jinx, you owe me a Coke.
Doesn't he have another one called District 80 or something?
I think so. Damn.
Damn, yeah. Hey, kids.
Ah, oh, crap. But yeah, Damn, To Pimp a Butterfly, and Good Kid, Mad City are, like, the best.
Got him.
Dang it. Aw, oh, man.
Get the fuck out of here!
Is that a kid? Big Game.
No, that's not what I am.
Hey, what are you doing taking off without me? Ow! I mean, seriously, just run me over with the car.
I'm trying to do this challenge. I know it looks like we're about to go into the storm, but trust me, if we do, we're not going to be in it for very long.
Big Game,
I'm trying to get this challenge done.
I'll go ahead
Big Game, we're not
going to
die.
Okay, fine. But if we die, then I'm totally blaming you.
I only got it. Okay, see, I already got it. Now we can head back to the storm.
Alright, cool. Oh, crap. Oh, shoot.
After we go to Rocky. Don't stop me. Yeah. Dude, what the?
Give us some better tunes. Certainly not
destructive. Okay, I get
whoa,
it.
Oh, just shot at. We're gonna shot at. Big Game, just shot at.
I know. We're good. Slowly became more like children. Picture me as a tadpole started. I see him. I'm just trying to get this challenge done. I started off as a Yale picture, only offering heaven, although they give you hell. Like, picture that. Scripture that. picture that brilliant sister from Sister Act that gave us the
miseducation, found those who missed the map
and gave them hope. Just one more game. Hold on, Austin, stay in.
Big game storm. Let's go. What are you doing? There you go.
I repaired our car. I told you we'd survive the game.
I know.
Picture me flying over the city. Picture me with a beauty whose soul is equally pretty. Picture me with a ruby that's redder than cherry stems. Picture me with a choir full of hers to sing hymns. Picture having action at Cali.
All right, let's get it.
Hold on, wait a minute, this kid. Hey, big game.
Got it.
Dang it, that was my kill. Good stuff. I'll Bogart all this.
Hey, Austin, there's a purple gun right there for you.
Purple gun? I'm happy with the guns I got.
Austin, I think they're right up this hill.
Let's stand front at the ready.
Yeah, they are right up this hill.
Hijacked our truck.
Oh, I blew out their tire, though.
Dang it. You didn't get him, though?
No. Austin, don't. There's like three of them over there. Honestly, not even worth it. We'll just meet him at the end game if needed.
Meet them at the end game if needed.
Yeah, I'm just saying we'll meet him at the end game. Like, lose the battle but win the war. What I mean by that is, don't fight him, but if we do have to, we'll fight him in the final four and then win the game, which wins us the war.
Oh. Dang it.
There's splash healing over there.
Ow. Big game, I'm getting shot at.
By those same kids or different?
Apparently.
Were they shooting you from up here?
Yeah.
Here, Austin, drink this.
I don't need the med kit.
I'll just take it in case. That's fine, we'll just go. You're full almost on health anyway.
Can you pick this up? Give me the bandage. Ow, what the hell?
They're still just shooting you from back there.
Storm.
Yeah, he hit me too, don't worry, dude. Dude's being a baby, dude.
Dude's being a wuss. We're trying to be more specific.
You gotta take cover, Austin, in this game. You can't just walk around in the open.
I know, I'm like trying to find cover.
Nah, I mean like behind trees and
stuff. Whoa.
Austin, he sent a rocket after you.
Ah, oh, crap. Yep. Shoot.
Alright,
oh,
I'm down.
Do you think you can revive me here, bro?
Oh, I downed him. Austin, I'm gonna come back.
You better. Never mind, I'm dead. I got eliminated.
Got him.
It's just you.
I killed him.
It's just you. God bless it. Bruh. So freaking close. You gotta be serious. You gotta be serious. Well, guys, I think that'll wrap up the season finale of Fortnite Fridays. I just want to say thank you guys very much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoy the finale that's coming up tomorrow. So I hope you guys are ready for the finale tomorrow. Just want to say thank you guys from the bottom of my heart for checking out Fortnite Fridays. Want to thank InfernoMan87 for joining me here tonight. Yeah, big shout out to him. Thank you for joining me. And that's it, guys. Be sure you guys hit that follow button as well. I will be back in 2 weeks with the season 3 premiere of... Not the season 3 premiere, but the season 2 premiere of Fortnite Fridays. You guys know what I mean. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you guys. Have a great night. Great weekend.